This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to explain how to find the volume of cylinders and prisms. So I've drawn a couple of prisms here. The first one is a triangular prism. It's got a triangle as both of the bases. Those triangles are parallel to each other and they're congruent with each other. Then I've got a rectangular prism. So the bases of a rectangular prism are rectangles, which are congruent with each other and parallel to each other. And I've got a cylinder. So for a cylinder, both of the bases are going to be circles that are parallel to each other and also congruent with each other. Now, to find the volume for each of these different figures, we can use a separate formula for each one. But what I want to use is a general formula that will work for any prism and also for any cylinder. That formula is going to be that the volume equals the area of the base times the height. So let's apply that formula to a couple of different figures. I'll start out with a triangular prism. So I've drawn a triangular prism here. Its height is 5 inches, and I've also drawn a separate picture of its base. So we can see that for the triangle that forms the base, it's got one side which is 4 inches long, and it's got an altitude that's 3 inches high. So the formula we're going to use again is that the volume of this prism will equal the area of the base times the height. We know what the height is, but we have to find the area of the base. The base is a triangle. We know the formula for the area of a triangle is the base times the height divided by 2. So the base is 4 and the height is 3, so I'll multiply 4 times 3, divide that by 2. 4 times 3 is going to be 12. When we divide 12 by 2, we'll have 6. So the area of the base is 6 inches, the height is 5 inches. That means the volume is going to be 6 inches, the area of the base, times the height, which is 5 inches, or 30 cubic inches. When you're dealing with volume, make sure that your unit measurements are cubic. Okay, so all we did was apply the formula. Volume is the area of the base times the height. We found out what the area of the base was, and then we multiplied that by the height. Okay, let's see how this works for a cylinder. So I've got a cylinder here. The height of the cylinder is 7 inches, and the circle that forms each of the bases has a diameter of 4 inches. So we're going to have to find the area of the base. That means we need the area of the circle. So the formula for the area of a circle is pi times the radius squared. We're not given the radius, we're given the diameter. But remember, the radius is 1/2 the diameter. So that means we're going to have pi times 2 squared. 2 squared is 4. So the area of each of the bases is going to be 4 pi. Then we'll take our formula for the volume of a cylinder or a prism. It's going to be that the volume is the area of the base times the height. The base has an area of 4 pi, and the height is 7. So we're going to end up with 28 pi, once again, that's cubic inches. And if we wanted to, of course, we could take that pi and either use a rough estimate for it, something like 3.14, or we could put it into a calculator, multiply it by 28, and we'd find out approximately how many cubic inches we have in this cylinder. Okay, so to recap the whole thing, for any cylinder or any prism, it doesn't matter if it's triangular prism or rectangular prism, or if the bases are pentagons or seven-sided figures or octagons. For any prism or any cylinder, the formula you can use to find the volume is going to be the area for the base times the height of the prism or the cylinder. Okay, and that's the whole thing. Take care. I'll see you next time.